How important is the salah? Does it take you outside the fold of Islam if you do not pray?
Okay, the scholars have differed on this subject. The majority of them say if you do not pray, believing in the prayer, then you're still considered to be a Muslim, but you're a disobedient Muslim. You're a Asi. You're a disobedient Muslim for not praying. And therefore the prayer is extremely important in our lives. It's the pillars of our deen. It's the pillars of our religion. You take away the pillars, you don't have religion. Not that I say you're a kafir, you're not a kafir. I believe that if someone believes in the prayer but does not pray, he's still considered to be a Muslim. But he is on the edge of kufr. He's on the edge of kufr because the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, what's between us and them is the prayer. And whoever leaves it becomes like them. If you don't care, if you do not care about your prayers, you don't care about Islam. It's general. You neglect your prayers, that means you are neglecting, I don't want to say 100% of Islam, 99% of Islam. So the prayer is very important, extremely important, so vital in our lives, and therefore, if you don't pray, you must start praying. And I ask you about Allah, how long does it take you to pray? It's not even half an hour a day. You know, the shortest movie that you watch a day is about 2 hours. Why is watching a movie 2 hours so easy? And when it comes to praying, 10, 15 minutes is so hard. And Allah has given you so much. Is it too much for you to give Him so little? Allah has given you so much. Is it too much for you to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that little? Allah has given you everything around you. You and everything around you belongs to Allah. And Allah has given you all that for free. So does it become too much for you to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that half an hour? I know at the beginning it's hard, but once you get yourself used to it, it becomes easy, inshallah.